Hi, today we are going to see some of the tools you need when you want to start making an open shoe or a sandal, a crafty sandal. People like calling it craft sandals, which is this one, because there's this flower here. So the tools you need, there are different tools you need. Most of some are for lining, cutting the lining, others for cutting the insole, cutting the sole, putting designs, and anything you want to do on the shoe. So our number one tool, we have a scissor. With this lining here, this is the one we use when we call it lining or a carpet, which is here. This one for put a sole. So this lining here, we use a scissor to cut it, which is this one. Straps, which are these ones, these ones here, we use a scissor because they are soft for a scissor to cut. Our strap material, the insole material, we all use a scissor to cut. Then we have a punch. This is a set of punch in different sizes. With this set, you need different sizes. Yeah, I'm seeing my 5/32. So this is size 5. I have this one here. It's the same as this one from here. This is size 5/16. This is 1/8. So there are different sizes and they serve different purposes. So with this one for a kid, this is a template for a kid sandal. If you're making a kid sandal, you need this small punch to make this hole here. So this hole here, in case you're doing a crafty sandal here, this is where you put. So you first have to use this small punch. Then with this big strap like this one here that goes through, now you need this big size. If you want to do this kind of the crochet here, first you need to make punch. You need to punch the strap one by one. So you can use this small one. First punch, then you can use your threads through it. So you have to first punch using this small punch. So that is the punch we are dealing with. Now we are going to a hammer. Why do you need some people ask why do you need a hammer? So we need a hammer and a mallet. With this hammer, if I'm punching using this punch, I'm going to put my lining on the insole here. I'll put somewhere where it is firm. I'll just bring my punch and do like this. And I punch using this hammer here. So with this one, this is our template. You just pass through this and it makes the mark where you have to punch from. Then you can punch using this hammer. So the hammer, we use it for punching. Then the mallet, this one, once we've put the gum on the shoe, if we've put gum here, this gum on a shoe like this lining here, then you attach it with the insole, then you start punching using this mallet. So the gum has to be firm. So you punch using this one here. Because it's not stronger like a hammer, it's just for making the gum stick. Even after putting the sole and your sand is done, you still have to punch it. So that is another thing. Then you need a template. Some people, they cut their templates and keep them. Others, they cut their templates like in the paper or in any material and they have to keep those templates. So for us, we use this material, which is Texon. That's where we cut our templates from. So if we are measuring, let's say I want to measure size 39 or size 40, and this is my size 39, I'll just come and measure using my template like this. Then I put the markings here. Then if I want the other leg, I'll just fold it and do like this. So for this one, I need one side, because I can fold the other side. So from the template, now we need a shoe last. A shoe last, For it, we use it, you can either use it like this, but for it, we also use it when we are measuring here. So in case I'm measuring the size of the waist here, I'll just come and measure using this one. Let's say someone puts 39, then I know that this is 39. I'll come and measure from here, which is 39. So even if I'm putting this one, I'll still use this. So I can either one have this or I can have this one. For this one, an added advantage, you can measure from here. So from there, I need size a punch for putting the size, which is this one here. This one is size 40. This one is 39. As you see, this is 39. This is 40 here. Then this here is 44. This one I put here is 44. So with this one, we use this punch. So with this punch, there's number 1, there is 0, then there is 6. So if you're punching 39, you need 3, then you have to punch 3 on the lining without the insole. You first cut put in the on the lining without putting the insole. So you have this 3 here. You come and punch using your hammer. You punch like this using the hammer. Then it goes there 3. Then you come and punch also 9. Next. So it will be 39. So you need these 2 for putting the sizes. Then again, there are some designs we put on our sandals. As you can see, there's this design, these designs which are here on this strap. And even here in the side of the lining. Then you have these ones also, which are like this. This one faces this side, this faces this side. Then you have this one as well. They are different. There's this one. They are different designs we put. So these designs are these ones. So we have this car. This car tool, which is this one here, which is on this shoe. Then we have this one here, which is here. Then we have this one, which is this one here. So you keep punching them. You have to use energy. The next you need is a ruler, because you have to measure the straps. You need your ruler with the measuring tape. They all go together. Those are some of the tools you need. Don't wait, start now. I mean, Rosette from Tandika Uganda, that trains women and girls how to make sandals as an income generating activity. Subscribe to our YouTube channel.